Hello, welcome to the USB to UART bridge demo as part of the housekeeping MCU training series. In this video, we will demonstrate how to use an MSP430 MCU to send data through USB or UART and receive the data on the other communication method. A USB to UART bridge is helpful when a translator is needed to move data from one communication method to the other in one simple program. The MSP430 waits for data to be received on either the USB or UART, and when the correct interrupt is triggered, we'll send the data to the opposite communication method. If either event is not observed, the MSP430 will loop, waiting for data. This demo will use a graphical user interface, or GUI, to set up the two terminals, one for USB and the other for UART, to send the data back and forth between the two communication methods. Let's get started. Overall, the GUI includes two of the same section. One terminal is labeled USB terminal, and the other terminal is labeled UART terminal. The labeling is used to keep track of the terminals, but doesn't prevent the user from changing ports. The terminal features include a COM port selector and a baud rate selector. For the correct COM port, look under your device manager. The USB COM port should show up as USB serial device, and the UART COM port should show up as MSP application UART1. The COM port for the USB device will only show up when the program is running, as the USB device needs to be initialized. For the baud rate, the UART should be set to 9600. The USB baud rate does not matter. When the program is running, click Connect under both sections to connect the GUI terminals to the COM ports. Click on the USB terminal and type. The result should display on the UART terminal. Now, click on the UART terminal and type. The display now shows up on the USB terminal. This demonstrates that the input from one channel becomes the output on the other channel. Let's take a look at the hardware needed for this demo. You will need the MSP430F5529 Launchpad Development Kit to run the example code. TI Launchpads include the basic hardware on one evaluation board, making your setup easier for this demo. More detailed information can be found on TI.com. Let's discuss the system overview, including the hardware connections needed. The system uses the MSP430F5529 Launchpad Kit. The isolation jumper pins need to be connected like the image shown. Besides the isolation jumpers and plugging in the USB, no other external connections need to be made. The Launchpad's back channel UART is used to communicate with the USB and GUI. This example specifically uses pins P4.4 and P4.5 for the UART communication. Make sure that TXD and RXD jumpers are populated on the isolation jumper block. Let's discuss the flowchart of the basic example code. The main program begins by initializing variables and configuring the pins, UART, clocks, and USB. Then, the program enters an infinite while loop, which will check for data received from the UART. If data is received on the UART side, then the data will be sent to the USB side. Next, the program checks to see if data is received on the USB side. If there is data received on the USB side, it will be sent to the UART side. The program will continue to loop until forced to end by the user or an error occurs. The USB ISR is used to clear flags from the USB side and handle the bus error that could occur. If there is a bus error, then the program will disable the USB and clear the error flag. Thanks for watching the video. Go ahead and try out the provided GUI yourself and check out the code example. The app brief is available to read for more specific design details. We hope you enjoy this video and come back to learn more about other MSP430 housekeeping topics. Have a great day.